You give us 3 minutes, and we give you the world. Good evening. I'm Casey Wong. A military submarine that went missing over 3 years ago has suddenly reappeared in the Baltic Sea. Confused seamen mistakenly opened fire on the last Lapland reservation, killing 12. Thankfully, our homesick sailors are back on U.S. soil. Welcome back, boys. In local news, a new crime wave that is sweeping Detroit has already claimed the lives of 21 police officers. Here's a statement from the head of OCP, Omni Consumer Products, that's funding and running the Detroit Police Department.
Old Detroit has a cancer, and that cancer is crime. It must be cut out, and OCP holds the scalpel.
According to our sources, the attacks were aimed at catching the attention of a man whose identity remains unknown. This dangerous new guy in town seems to have his eye on doing business in old Detroit.
Your filthy hands off me. Shut up.
I'm sorry. There seems to be a
disturbance? I'm a big fan. Now move. Don't adjust your television sets. Your regularly scheduled program will be back shortly. Now, this message goes out to the new guy in town. It seems that you're looking to spend some money in this great city of ours. I'm here to tell you that the Torchheads are open for business. You may have heard of us as the number one supplier of nuke in old Detroit. The most potent, addictive drug available in front of every convenience store, school, or library near you. But that's not all we're capable of. Let's get you up here. We'll get Officer Howard to illustrate the point. You see, Officer Howard made a drug bust that cost us a lot of money. We want to reward this dutiful officer with a performance bonus. A lifetime supply of nuke. Oh man, you're gonna have the time of your life. There you go. Enjoy. New guy, us Torchheads are more than capable of doing whatever you need done in our city. So what is it, huh? Arson, smuggling, drug dealing, good old-fashioned murder? We do it all. You've got the money. We've got the power. So let's talk.
Good to see you, Murphy. Lieutenant's at the main entrance to the TV station.
The ground's shaking. Judgment Day's here!
Hey, handsome. We're here for the show.
They came out of the trucks and they just started shooting at anything that moved.
I can see your lady's storm.
I wouldn't bother. I already ran the plates.
You should know by now, when it comes to evidence, we're hoarders.
If it keeps on like this, we're gonna run short of body bags. I'm gonna give you 10 milligrams of diazepam to make you comfortable.
Longer. Those trigger-happy maniacs have a ton of hostages.
Leave the
out, sir. Roger that. Over and out.
What is the situation?
Goddamn OCP tells us to stand down till SWAT arrives. That's our situation.
Looks like I'm on the way out.
Not so fast, buddy. Who do you think is gonna clean up this place? I'm not letting you off that easily.
You sound just like my wife.
If that's the case, let's get you patched up. We wouldn't want to get on her bad side. Press here. Medic! There you are, partner.
Lewis.
The hell is going on up there?
Sorry, dude! The police want us to release the hostages! So no hard feelings!
Hey! You can't go in yet! We need to wait for the reinforcements!
Reinforcements have arrived.
I knew you'd say something like that.
We need to find another way. It is too dangerous to cross.
For me. But you can take the heat. Go, I'll figure something out. Besides, you could do with a head start. Go on.
I've got a signet ring. How much do you think I could get for it?
Is it gold?
It was taken off someone famous. Just look at him. He looks kind of familiar.
Guys! We've got company. Anyone expecting a silver freak?
Drop it, scum.
Just look who it is!
Thank you. Warning.
Worried about the weight limit?
Lewis, you're here.
We need to get these elevators back online. The service box is in the basement.
Let me.
I doubt you had time between all the heroics, but I got a keycard from the janitor. It's good to do some real street work from time to time, you know? After you. They sabotaged the elevators and staircase too. They obviously don't want to be disturbed.
That graffiti is fresh.
I bet some of those idiots are still here.
It's that metal devil! Oh shit, it's RoboCop!
Any more tricks up your sleeve?
I will keep.
What a warm welcome, don't you think?
Hand off!
That service box, isn't it? Hey, why don't you check it out?
I am detecting a short circuit. We need to isolate the cables.
I think I've got something just for that.
You are very resourceful.
Thanks, but I'd say it was a team effort. They're holding everyone in the studio. It's on the 30th floor.
Finally decided to join our glamorous show. I'm afraid you're too late for my autograph.
Chopper's ready.
I've gotta go, but the party goes on. Guys, make sure you provide all our guests with a decent amount of amusement, so don't skimp on the nuke. See ya.
What a freaking psycho. We need to be quick before they kill anyone else. I know that look, Murphy. You saw something, didn't you?
We are here to enforce the law, Lewis. Let us stay focused.
Right. Just keep in mind that I'm here if you need me, partner.
Slime bags detected.
Just look at that, boys! The police dog and its bitch!
Not sure which one is which.
You're gonna take that back.
Thank you.
Thank God you've come. This lady really needs to see a doctor.
Murphy, these people need help. Why don't you go ahead? I'll stay with them.
Right.
This is Lewis. We have rescued three hostages, one with a gunshot wound to the abdomen, requesting urgent medical assistance. Over.
Thank you.
get the napkins from the cupboard.
Sure thing, Mom. What are we having?
It's a surprise. Little man, have you washed your hands?
Do I really have?
Alex? What do you think about the color of this dress? I'm not sure if I like the pattern. James really looks up to you. He said in school that he wants to be a police officer, just like his dad.
We cannot let him pass! Kill them!
Another one of those choppers, like the one that took Soot! You hear me?
You work so hard, honey. Why don't you take some leave? We all could use a little break from this reality, don't you think?
Wakey wakey! I'm talking to you, Shiny! Stand back from that door, or I'll shoot her! I swear to Nuke!
I don't know what I would do if I ever lost you.
You got 3 seconds! Three!
Our family is the only thing I need to be happy.
Two! Are you fucking deaf?
Promise me, we will stay like this forever.
One! Last chance, weirdo!
I love you so much, James.
You okay there, Murphy? What does it want? Get it away from me!
I am sorry.
Can you see? It's unstable!
Ma'am, please, calm down. It's been a very tough evening, and I assure you that everyone wants to be back home with their families. Though for some of us, the night has just begun.
Bail now. Cash? No problem. Do you take singles?
Get back in line.
They're here. Good job, Murphy.
I think you're forgetting someone.
Officer Lewis, you were remarkable.
Soot ran off with his tail between his legs.
Would have been nice if we caught him, though.
All right. Are you done with this circle jerk, huh? Good. We've got a problem.
The malfunction caught on camera provokes a question. Can we put our safety into the hands of a machine? Especially one as unreliable as RoboCop. We asked Max Becker, the head of security concepts at OCP.
Now quiet!
We would never put a defective product on the streets. That's not what we do.
We all saw it hesitate in a life and death situation. Why? Does it really know right from wrong?
Listen, I would trust this guy with my kids. I mean, if I had any. This was just an isolated glitch. Thank you.
Mr. Becker, I've got more questions.
I just want to snap her little neck. But she's got a point. This was not an isolated incident. It's a pattern. A pattern that the old man wants examined and fixed. Time to see what's hiding in that metal head of yours.
We know what's in Murphy's head. It's what's in yours that worries us.
Push me, and you might just find out. You, follow me.
Everyone is dismissed. And Lewis, I need your report on the TV station incident. On the double.
On it, Sarge.
God damn it, when will this be fixed?
Don't hold your breath. OCP isn't looking to spend a dime on our equipment.
There's my favorite walking, talking law enforcement machine.
Okay, let's get on with it.
Why don't you take a seat for me? That's a nasty scar. I'd like to see the other guy. Am I right?
You do not. Trust me.
Don't mind me. I'll just get this off.
So, here's the deal, Robo. The old man is not happy with your performance. Instead of sending you to the scrapyard, as I suggested, he wants to fix you. Hey, pretty boy. You sure know how to make an impression on the ladies.
Doesn't it hurt him?
Hurt? Lady, he's a machine. He's legally dead. We can do whatever we want with him.
No, madam. It does not hurt me physically.
So we're going to equip you with a little monitoring chip. It will do a real-time check of your systems so we can get to the bottom of what the hell is wrong with you. From now on, your performance will be monitored and graded. So better be on your best behavior, huh?
The chip is in. Let's see what we have here. Well, I can already see some unwanted activity in your hippocampus. We'll have to keep an eye on it. Other than that, everything seems to be installed correctly. To be sure, let's make a simple test to check that all circuits are in order. What are your prime directives?
Serve the public trust. Protect the innocent. Uphold the law.
Okay, nothing disturbed. However, like with any new upgrade, I recommend visiting the range to check if you need calibration.
Is that everything?
Actually, no. Doctor?
Oh, yes, sorry. My name is Dr. Olivia Blanche. I'm a police psychologist. I specialize in dealing with police officers suffering from emotional trauma.
Emotional trauma? Might as well talk to the microwave. It hasn't been working properly either.
OCP wanted to see if you'd be willing to have a talk with me as part of your evaluation. I noticed that a great deal of care has been put into making sure that your mechanical components work. However, one aspect of your composition that has been severely neglected is your human side, your brain.
I agree. If it was up to me, I'd remove it altogether. What do you think, Doctor? Would save us a lot of hassle.
I don't mind the hassle. So what do you say, Officer? Is that possibly something that could be of interest to you?
I am not sure.
Robo, Reed wants everyone in the briefing room in 5. It's about the new guy.
Excuse me, Dr. Blanche, but I am needed elsewhere.
But we...
Well, can't say we didn't try. Everyone get back to whatever the fuck you usually do around here.
Man, I tell you, it was crazy in that TV station. Good job you had Murphy. Him, we'd all be goners.
Murphy, could you please help me out here?
Murphy, I heard you're scheduled for calibration. Step right up and press the button when you're ready. 50 points is what OCP calls a passing grade. Shouldn't be a problem to you. Unless you want to try to break the record. Good job. I'll let the eggheads know that you're good to go. See you in the briefing room.
Hi, Murphy.
Oh, man. No, I just can't do it. There is no way.
So, what's on today's agenda?
Could you give me a hand?
It's no secret that crime has been on the rise ever since what the media has named the new guy in town showed up in the city. The word on the street is that he wants to spend a lot of money in old Detroit, and that has made every gang in the city start advertising their services. We need to find him before things get out of control.
Where do we look?
Our best bet is to see if he made contact with the Torchheads. Robo, I want you to start by checking the arcade downtown. It's become a high activity area for punks.
Understood.
Everyone else, keep your eyes open. Any questions?
Any word on Briggs?
What happened to Briggs?
He's been missing since yesterday.
Shit.
Officer Briggs remains missing. That's over 24 hours since he's been in contact with anyone here.
Are the two cases connected?
No reason to assume so. But if anyone finds Briggs' informant, we might learn something new. All right, now get out there!
You go ahead, partner. I need to write this report. And there's something else I need to do first.
Cruiser's ready for you, Robo. Go get him.
City, didn't you? It'd be easier to burn it all to the ground.
Could you please keep the noise down? You're scaring off my customers.
Can't hear you. Music's too loud.
Crap! Give me back my money, you piece of shit!
Don't you cops ever get bored with harassing successful entrepreneurs?
Hey! This shit is rigged!
That's a serious accusation, kiddo. Someone might think I would allow such illegal activity in my high-class business, which I do not. I get lost.
You work for Soot. Tell me where to find him.
You cops are giving me a stomach ulcer. Stop asking me about guys I don't know.
Withholding information can lead to bigger trouble than a stomach ulcer.
Look, I'm a busy man, so I'm going back to my office now. Why don't you join me there, and we'll talk. Oh, on second thought, you can't do that, because you don't have a warrant, do you?
What a douchebag.
Come back with a warrant, cop!
Man, such amazing colors. And there's not one, but two of you? From now on, I promise, I will cherish you more often.
Your body readings suggest substance misuse.
Oh man, a real like TJ laser? You are so incredibly shiny. I'm definitely getting more of this stuff.
Who sold you drugs?
I really shouldn't say, but you are my TV heroes. All right. All of the arcade staff will sell to you, as long as you got cash. Unfortunately, I'm broke, but I have a great idea. You could help me sneak into the basement. They keep a huge stash of goodies down there.
Drugs in the basement? I will take care of that.
Would you really do that for me? Way to go, TJ! Is that the ocean?
Open the door. I have the warrant.
Oopsie. I think I dropped my key somewhere. You'd have to break down this hardened door if you want to get in.
That will not be a problem.
It's RoboCop!
Surrender your weapons.
No chance!
Thank you. Open the door, or you will regret it.
Can't a guy just sell drugs to kids without you harassing him every 5 minutes? Who am I hurting, huh? They all want it.
Where do I find Soot?
Well, if that's the case...
Shut it, bozo! Unless you want to end up in the ghost house like that cop's informant!
And don't you dare open that door, I'll shoot you!
Have it your way.
Just stormed into my office. Apparently, his niece's car has been stolen. Find it. This goes to the top of your priority list. You can start by asking about it at some of the local garages. For the record, it's a blue SUX 6000, registered to Melissa Kuzak.
Hey, I might be a little late filing my tax return, but sending a one-man army seems like an overreaction.
I am here to investigate the theft of a blue SUX 6000 that belongs to Melissa Kuzak.
Fancy car and fancy name. But I hardly ever get the pleasure of dealing with either.
Do you have any information about the whereabouts of this vehicle?
To be honest, I did some work on one of those cars recently. But I can assure you that it was not the one you're looking for.
Do I have your permission to search the shop?
I know what the world's like, but can a man go about his business without being harassed all the damn time?
Citizen, I would like to inform you that knowingly delaying an investigation is classified as a felony.
Yada, yada, yada. I don't have all day to listen, nor do I understand this bureaucratic jargon.
Would you like to call your lawyer and have him explain it to you?
You know what? If you really think you'll find evidence of that SUX ever being here, then be my guest. See, I've told you, you'll find Jack all, because there ain't nothing to be found. This place is legit.
I need access to one of your lockers.
I can't allow that. It's my worker's private possessions.
You said your shop has nothing to hide.
The locker you have in mind belongs to a boy named Scott. He works for me on and off. I have to admit, I had a tiny feeling he might have something to do with your case. I will open his locker for you, but I won't be held accountable for what's inside. That's his locker. Go on, have a look. And what do you reckon? Is he your man?
For the time being, where is the suspect?
You see, he hasn't turned up for work for some time. This morning, when two thugs swung by looking for him, I knew he must be in trouble. I've overheard him many times talking about a place where he does car jobs on the side.
Give me the precise location.
I can't tell you exactly where it is. All I know is that it's one of the garages near the local storage compartments.
Tell me why you think he is responsible.
He's young, bright, and would like to rule the world. I get it. But nearly every month, he gets himself in trouble.
It is not enough to make assumptions.
I'm not a cop, but I've seen many things in my life, and where there's smoke, there's usually fire.
Why did you cover for him?
I can't watch a decent kid like him get swallowed by this city. Don't look at me like that. Instead of giving him up, I was encouraging him to come clean. But a man can only try.
Is he a temporary worker?
You could say that. We fall out a lot because he brings a lot of hot stuff to the shop, and I'm not okay with it.
And you let him come back?
It's hard to make an honest living these days. That's why I understand his struggle, and I let him come back. Working here keeps him out of trouble. And to be frank, it's not easy to find such a good mechanic either.
That is all for now.
Hey! Make sure no harm comes his way. He might have done some foolish things in the past, but he's a good kid, and he deserves another chance.
A court of law will be the judge of that.
God, I messed up good.
You must be Scott. What did you do with the blue SUX-6000 that you stole?
Hey, well, why would I have anything to do with that?
I have found evidence in Ben's shop.
You can't possibly help me. I don't want to cause any more trouble, especially for Ben.
Admitting to a crime is the best course of action for any young offender.
I can't go to juvie. Who's gonna fix this mess?
My duty is to serve the public trust.
Okay. I admit, it was me who jacked the SUX. But he didn't leave me any choice.
Who is he?
I can't tell you. If he knew I gave him away, he'd take revenge on Ben. Oh God, it must be those thugs. We're dead. No one is going to save us.
If they are criminals, then they are the ones who need saving.
Hello? Anybody home? Where are you, Scotty boy? You can only hide for so long. Oh, shit. It's the metal pick. Blast!
I'm gonna kill you for this!
I got him!
I'm hit! I'll kill you for this!
You did it! They didn't think that through. Maybe you can put an end to this after all.
I am missing vital information in order to resolve this case.
I'll tell you what you want. Just please, help me fix this screw-up.
Where is the car now?
Oh man, I'm sure it's still in their chop shop. It's a warehouse on the northeast side. The entrance is concealed, but I'm sure you'll find it. I'm no fighter, but if there is any other way, I would like to help. Maybe you need some more intel.
Who did you mean by him?
It's Rex, from the local gang. I only did petty jobs for him mostly, but this time he made me steal that car. He said he wanted the SUX-6000 we were repairing at Ben's. When I said it was too hot, he slashed me with his knife.
Why were you hiding?
You saw those thugs. They were looking for me. They realized I tricked them. They wanted the SUX-6000 from Ben's shop, but I didn't want to get him into trouble, so I stole a different one. I doubt anyone would have given a shit, but word on the street is that it belongs to the mayor's niece.
Any criminal matters should be reported to the police.
I know. I just thought I could figure this out by myself. Ben was right from the start. I shouldn't have gone down this road.
That is all for now. Proceeding to the vehicle's estimated location.
You are calling for backup, aren't you?
Negative. Threat calculation minimal.
Who's there? Oh, it's only you.
Citizen, I'm ordering you to discontinue this deliberate act of vandalism.
Screw you, man!
Thank you.
I can't believe you've actually done it! Do you think I could take that car back to the owner and say I'm sorry? Maybe she won't press charges.
This car is now in police custody.
Oh, please, I could really use a helping hand right now. Otherwise, I'm back in juvie.
Proceeding to secure the perimeter. Keys are in the ignition.
Thank you so much! I promise I won't mess this up!
It's that metal freak!
You need to be taught some manners.
Just look at the metal motherfucker!
Come on!
Are you the police informant? Do you know where I can find Soot?
Oh man, all great questions, but could you untie me first? They really outdid themselves with these knots.
Talk.
Hey, I don't know how you usually operate, but that type of information don't come free.
It is a privilege and a merit for civilians to assist the police in capturing wanted fugitives.
Well said. What can I say? I'm a sucker when it comes to helping the cops. So, it seems that the new guy saw the punks attack on the TV station and decided to meet with Soot on their turf. The meeting is supposed to take place tonight during Soot's concert.
Concert?
I know. I'm not really a fan of his music myself. But that's not what those shows are really about. Why don't we, get out of here, huh?
Lewis, Soot is meeting the new guy tonight at the old slaughterhouse.
Copy that. Pick me up at the station. I'll grab my gear. By the way, I've got something for you, Murphy.
They call me Pickles. There's a funny story behind that name. This one time, I saw Torchhead stealing a delivery truck. I went after them, hoping that a VCR would fall off the back of the truck, you know? But it turned out to be groceries, so they left it. I made a pretty penny that day selling pickles. Still have a couple of jars laying around if you want them.
So you are an opportunist.
Hey, I prefer street entrepreneur. You know what they say, a good business is where you find it. Nice to be free again. Thanks, Tin Man. Hey, did Briggs tip you off that I might be here?
Officer Briggs?
Yeah, he's my police go-to guy.
Officer Briggs is missing.
Missing? Shit. May our city have mercy on him.
How do you know Officer Briggs?
We go back a long way. He gave me a helping hand when I hit rock bottom. And I've been in his debt ever since. He even introduced me to his family. Great kid and wife, though his missus don't seem very fond of me.
You seem proficient in undertaking police tasks. Ever thought of making a living out of it?
Oh, no. One thing you should know about me. I love cops, you know. Law enforcement, laws, all of that. I think those are great ideas. But so is Nuke. And when I need it, I tend to forget about the other stuff. So, you know what they say. You can only serve one master.
Do you think Briggs is in trouble?
I really don't know. Last time I saw him, he was going to check a case of missing bodies. Sounded like a bogus lead, so I didn't press him. Funny enough. He always tells me to be careful when getting info. But the truth is, I'm not the one running around gangster's paradise dressed in blue.
Need to go. Duty awaits.
About that. I've got a favor to ask. I know that Briggs is missing, but I've got something that belongs to him. He must have misplaced it the last time he visited my crib. And it's kind of weighing me down.
What is it?
It's his wristwatch. Now, I feel bad holding on to it. Could you please give it back to his family?
This is stolen property, and you expect me to return it?
Gee, That sounds bad when you say it like that, but still, you shouldn't let me hold on to expensive things. That's how I ended up in this situation in the first place.
I will make sure they receive it from the repentant thief.
Oh, boy. You're a tough negotiator. But surely you don't mean now. I gotta chillax after all this.
I have more urgent matters on hand. Meet me later at Briggs' place.
Yeah, you gotta save the city. That's fine by me. I'll see you later.